Hey guys, Osama here. You asked for it and I have it here. Here are the tips and tricks for the Samsung Galaxy A70. These tips will unleash the real potential of your Samsung Galaxy A70. Before we go ahead, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit that bell icon too. And let's start now. So the very first tip is the use of quick toggles. Samsung has added extended features in the quick toggles this time. If you just open the quick toggles and click on any toggle's name, you can access its settings. Let's say you click on the torch, you can set the torch intensity. For example, I am clicking on the torch here, and this is how you can set its intensity right out of the quick toggles. If you go to the blue light filter, you can change its opacity right from here. These extended options are there for almost all the quick toggles. The next tip is to add the brightness bar in the notification screen. By default, you have to pull down the toggles to access it. To get it in the notifications panel, click on the brightness bar settings and click on appear on the top. You can now access it straight away from the notifications bar anytime. The next tip is the use of night mode, which is now a part of the Samsung One UI. Just pull down the notifications panel and enable the night mode from the quick toggles. It's gonna save you some battery on the Super AMOLED screen, and this is how the night mode looks in the stock applications of the Samsung Galaxy A70. Next up is the use of navigation gestures. To enjoy the full 6.7 inches screen of your Samsung Galaxy A70, open settings, go to display, and then go to navigation bar. In the navigation bar, click on navigation gestures and enable them. You have the gestures now. Enjoy using the phone by swiping the screen. In the display settings, you have the screen mode too. The screen mode can change the colors. You can use the vivid or any other color settings that you want. Within the same display settings, you have the screen zoom too. If you don't like the big elements on the screen, just swipe this bar to change the screen zoom according to your liking. Once again, in the display settings, we have the full screen apps. By default, the phone hides the notch while playing a game or using any other stock application. If you don't want to hide the notch, open settings, display settings, full screen apps, and click on the app that you want to run in the full screen. For example, I want to play PUBG Mobile in the full screen. I will just click on PUBG Mobile and I will select full screen. PUBG Mobile will no longer hide the notch. Another useful tip regarding the display is regarding the always on display. Open settings, lock screen, always on display, display mode. You can change the settings here, whether you want always on display to appear all the time you want, or you just want it to appear when you tap the screen. Previously, the always on display used to appear all the time, so Samsung added this option to make it appear when you tap the screen. And this is a really useful feature since it saves a little bit of battery that the always on display used to consume before. Let's head over to the camera now. You can move the camera button. Just drag the camera button anywhere on the screen. This is going to be a really useful feature for the selfies. You can also change the screen mode in the camera application. You can go full 16:9 or any other mode. If you don't like the default scene optimizer, you can turn it off too. The next tip is to reduce animations. Default animations can slow your phone down. Open settings, go to advanced settings, and here you can find the reduce animations button. This will improve the performance of your phone. Performance in a sense, it will load up the elements a little bit faster. The next tip is to change the grid layout. Long press the home screen and then click on the home screen settings. You can change the grid for both the app drawer and the home screen. You can also rotate the home screen of your phone into the landscape mode. Here is how you can do it. This is a really useful feature for gamers. One of the most useful features of the Galaxy A70 is the interaction control. open settings, go to accessibility, in the accessibility, go to interaction and dexterity, turn on the interaction control from here. What this mode will do is, it locks down a certain area of your phone's screen. Let's suppose you want to show a picture to some relative but you don't want them to see any other thing in your phone, you can block the entire screen. Open any picture, any application or anything else on your phone and long press the volume up and power button. You will see the interaction control like this. Now either create a box or select the full screen. You can see that the screen has become unresponsive now. Interaction control can be turned off by pressing the same volume up plus power button. Next feature is similar to the interaction control but it locks down a certain application. This is the pin window feature. Open settings, go to biometrics and security and click on other settings, pin windows and then turn it on. So what pin windows does is, let's suppose you want to show YouTube to a kid but you don't want the kid to go out of YouTube. You will simply open YouTube and then go to the recent apps. Click on the YouTube icon and then click on pin window. You can see that YouTube has been locked on the screen now. One cannot go out of YouTube. To turn off pin windows, long press the recents plus back key. Next step is to use multi windows on the new One UI. Most users think that Samsung has removed the multi window mode, but it's still there. To use the multi window, simply open the recent apps, click on the app icon. Now click on split view. You can now add any other application to run in parallel with your first application. The next cool feature is the use of video wallpaper. Simply open the gallery and swipe the screen like this. Now click on videos. Open any video and click on the menu button. Now set this video as a wallpaper. You can set a 15 second clip as a wallpaper. The last feature in this list is the file sharing. Samsung has added smart file sharing. You can share heavy files within seconds now. For example, open any file on your phone like this, click on the share button and then click on send to device. The phone will now start looking for another Samsung phone. I have the Galaxy A50 here. I will open the smart view on the Samsung Galaxy A50. You can see that the A70 has now detected A50 and I can send the file now. You can send a file via Wi-Fi direct similarly. So that's all with the Samsung Galaxy A70 tips and tricks. I hope you guys find this video useful. Thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you loved it. I will see you in the next one.